bouncing puck off the draw, came close to going over Demko. Beagle clears the puck to the corner, and the slump for Vancouver is over. But the game apparently is not.
One more huddle for good measure.
Kachuk. Glove punches against Alex Edler.
I don't know what's preventing Beagle from dropping the gloves right now, because I think it's time. You're going to take 10 shots in the chin, and they're going to let you do it.
Clearly, Edler targeted for his hit on both Kachuk and Lindholm tonight. And Matthew Kachuk was really giving it to him with his glove on, and Edler is just taking it because he's got the win.
I'll tell you, this is how it's going to go all year long, and these two teams just building that dislike for one another to carry over to the next game. And it was a pretty tame game, really, a physical, hard-fought game, but not a lot of dirty stuff at the end, a little chippier. And
you can tell the Ducks want to make something happen here in the dying seconds. Clock ticks down, and this series is tied, but it's not over.
Yeah, Brian Allen was going after Jordy Benn. Here we go.
Line brawl to end.
Here we go.
Brian Allen got cleared out of there. We've got Eakin and Raquel.
Mistrick on top of, is it Goligoski down there? No, Goligoski, Smith-Pelly, and
would it be Daly?
Did Daly get former teammates?
Well, let's see. Goligoski's there with Smith-Pelly.
And this is exactly what Lindy Ruff was talking about. He saw this coming. Oh, it's Garvin.
Oh, it's Garvin.
Yeah, Garvin shouldn't be surprised.
Stay tuned, game five, Friday night.
It'll be 7 points out of a possible 8 over the last 4 games. And This one is over.
Yeah, we got Lemieux now and Dillon.
Dillon.
And what happened was Lemieux went to the front of the net, and there was contact made with the goaltender, Vanacek.
Hathaway in a wrestling match here.
And Lemieux.
With Boteto.
Now Dillon off. That's
Rooney. Dillon.
And Dillon.
And this is the first of 8 meetings. So this will be in the memory books of the players.
I'll tell you what, Rooney has earned a spot on this team.
Tries to throw it back. Ekman Larson, sharp angle. It's going to roll around. Bakker shoots, and that's going to do it. And Shane Doan going after somebody. I think he wanted a piece of wrist to line, and that started prior to the faceoff, I believe, Tyson.
Well, it happened after Doan roughed up O'Reilly. And this is just a frustrated Coyotes team. That went 0-for-5 tonight on the power play. A power play that has got hot, and oh man, that's still going on right now. Who is that? That's Duclair getting worked over by somebody, and things are getting out of control here. Oliver Ekman-Larsson in the middle of that, and the Coyotes are going to want to be careful with that one, and Shane Doan is looking, and he's trying to get in there. He is the last thing that anyone wants to see.
Yeah, this one is going kook show in a hurry. Bogosian's in there. Ekman-Larsson's in there. Now Bogosian has Ekman-Larsson down and 2 guys on Ekman-Larsson. Larson and Bogosian still having words. And almost the entire Buffalo team is on the bench and kind of congregating around, and Anthony Duclair having words.
That is amazing. Far circle. Brody. Hell is by Landeskog, and that's going to do it at the XL Energy Center. It's game one of the 2 games in St. Paul as Rantanen has his lid ripped off, and now we've got anger spilling over. Mikko Rantanen wants a piece of Dubba in the worst kind of way. Landeskog is yanking on Dubba. Landeskog is getting yanked on. Rantanen reaching through the linesman. Here's McKinnon in the mix, and Talbot trying to get a piece of Taves. Where is Philip Grubauer? He wants to come on down, and why not, Phil? Let's have a little throwback time here. I'm all for it. You know that, Peter. Reeves and Hartman are there. Rantanen has just been stewing for about a week. And somebody's going to feel... Oh, and there we go. Talbot is still in the mix. What's Mikko saying, Phil? I can't read lips. Dumba and McKinnon finally separate. And I guess cooler heads will prevail here after the final horn, as the Avs go to Minnesota and run the point streak to 15 straight games and their third straight victory over the Wild.
Daniel Sedin with his 14th career overtime goal. The streak is over. Henrik Sedin skated by the Florida bench and had words, and now Dorsett is challenging Al Montoya.
And here
look
we go.
Out.
Look out, Scout.
You haven't seen this in a while. Henrik Sedin appeared to start this right after the goal went in. He went to the Florida bench, had words, and now we have trouble brewing.
Oh, this is old-time hockey.
Panthers coming back from the dressing room. I don't know who Henrik was talking to. And Luongo having words now through the pile, and we're not done yet.
Some of the Canucks have gone already. The coaching staff in particular, Glenn Collison's out there trying to calm down his crew.
Gerard Gallant.
Gerard Gallant was in a testy mood after last night's game, and you can see now this is continuing on. Ryan Miller's involved.
They'll be here.
Well, Al Montoya was one of the guys, and when the backup goalie gets involved, that's where Ryan Miller's talking to Al Montoya right now.
And Gerard Gallant is being held back by the linesman.
And you can see Gerard Gallant. Yeah. They look at Glenn Gullickson now, and Gerard Gallant, they're going at it verbally.
I don't know how many people saw the initial fly by the bench from the Canuck captain. And I don't know who he was talking to while the rest of the Canucks were celebrating in center ice. And that seemed to spark everything.
And you can see Henrik Sedin now is trying to wave the Canucks off after a big win. And another come from behind win, John, where they hadn't before this homestand, they hadn't come from behind the entire season. And they've done it twice now in these seven games.
The streak is over for the Panthers. It ends at 12. And it ends with some tension.
Clock draining down low. It hit Tkachuk. He goes down. Muzzin's got it. And it's a Maple Leaf win here in Calgary tonight. And now it's Tkachuk going after Muzzin.
And Muzzin at the very end just kind of flipped the puck towards Matthew Tkachuk. And Tkachuk didn't like it very much.
Well, we had a little extracurricular after the horn on Sunday. And Tkachuk was in the middle of it. And a similar circumstance here.
And a pretty harmless play, but you know that Muzzin recognized that it was Matthew Tkachuk that was there, and you think of the last game and some of the antics that went on, and just right here, look at this, just a little shot towards him, nothing major, but Tkachuk, of course, isn't gonna like that. But you think of Frederik Andersen, and you can see Tkachuk going off, just frustrated.